on to the last item, and it is going to be presented by Dr. Johnson, and it is on the local alternative teacher preparation report.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
And Cynthia Martin is making her way up here. She is a professional development leadership coordinator who had a significant role in organizing this process and the review process, and also entering in conversations and getting feedback from the group. So let me start by saying, if you remember, back in September, we shared the request for proposal with you all for the local alternative teacher preparation program. At that time, Mr. Davis asked if there were any funding attached to it. And at that time, I reported there was not, due to the dates and alignment. Since that time, with House Bill 1030, dates were aligned with the funding allocation. So that, as you can see in the materials, there is funding attached as well. While you have a copy of the actual proposal, I'm hoping that the PowerPoint here will just highlight the important aspects of it. While we had several inquiries from different groups that were interested in this, we ended up with one proposal, and that's the Central Carolina Local Alternative Teacher Preparation Program. And that is the group in Central Carolina Local Alternative. It's the Central Carolina RESA with Wake County. And if you look in the proposal on page 6 and 7, you'll see that there are 18 districts that are participating in this. So I want you to know that just because it says Central Carolina, it's not Wake County. It is 18. It's Wake, and it includes Northampton, and you can see the full list on those two pages. So it's important to note that the goals that they outlined was the teacher pipeline responsibility of growing your own, resting with the districts, and these districts agreed to make this a focus. And so it has a recruitment component, which is really important, as well as improving the quality of high-need schools assignments. And unique is working within the context of the school. So the participants would actually have a mentor in the school, and they would also have an instructional coach from the district. So they would get feedback and advice and have observations from different people, as well as peers in the school. Now, this is a snapshot of the requirements. On the left-hand side, you'll see the requirements from the session law and what the Central Carolina LATP proposal outlines. Important to note, minimally, it was 150 contact hours. This group has outlined 248 hours of study. I want to point out, in terms of critical friends, you'll see East Carolina and the NC School of Science and Math. But I want to point out that the education schools for the deaf and blind, UNC and NC State, are all affiliate members and will be called upon, but these were their two main critical friends for this project. The other point I want to make, I mentioned the coaches, instructional coaches and mentors. You'll see that in addition to the requirements for the comprehensive observation cycle, these participants would receive a minimum of 6 additional observations as well to get feedback and to help their growth. And again, the 18 districts are joining in on this. This slide talks about the elements. I want to point out, in addition to the application process, the candidates will be selected, and they highlighted selection was based on many elements from the Teach for America selection model, and that is included on page 9 and 10. If you are unfamiliar with that, they look at applicant achievement, leadership experience, actual interviews with the candidates, equity, motivation, and critical thinking. So that just gives you a summary of that. Also noted is that RTI, the Research Triangle Institute, has facilitated and helped this group come up with the planning. And I want to point out that this same group was very instrumental with our Leadership Academy development and has worked very closely with us in the past. Also, they worked a lot with Guilford County Schools Alternative Certification Track. They use that as a model, as Guilford County has been doing this for about 5 or 6 years. Funding sources, there is a participant fee of $1,000 one time for the 3-year program. And the district fee, collectively, they will collect $182,378, and the group will determine how that will occur. Central Carolina RESA, $50,000, and that is basically for, if I go back to the other slide, the staff, the professional development for the program administrator, lateral entry specialist, recruiter, and contracted licensure coordinator, should they need it. The $300,000 you see there will be secured once that you all agree to this and approve this proposal. This is the timeline for implementation and review, and you'll see that an independent research organization will be evaluating this program and reporting to you on a regular basis. And Mr. Martez Hill is conducting that process of identifying who that independent research organization will be. One more thing I want to say about this. This is a 3-year program, and the first year focuses on coursework. The second year focuses on very intensive coaching and mentorship. The third year will depend upon the success of the candidates, and it will be on a customized and differentiated model on how much is needed. Now, some of you may ask and wonder, so I'm going to just go ahead and address this. Why only one submission? If you look at the proposal, it is quite a bit of an extreme amount of planning. Human capital has to be devoted to this process, and there is, of course, funding issues as well. And while this pilot is new with some additional requirements, we do have under TCP B010 a current policy that allows for proposals for innovative programs for lateral entry teacher licensure. And in fact, one of those will be coming to you per that policy in, I believe, April. Any questions?
Are there any questions or comments? My one question, Dr. Johnson, back to the number of contact hours, the 248 program of study hours.
Yes, ma'am.
How are those content areas determined, like foundations for teaching and learning?
Well, they are determined because this preparation program is targeted at grades 6 through 12. So what they are doing is working with ECU, NC State, and UNC at our current program approval process and looking at what already is required for this. And in the programs of study, there's typically already outlined. And so these groups are coming together. That was part of this planning process to see, okay, where's our need? What content areas do we need to focus on? And where are our content experts to come together and provide this?
Okay, very good. Thank you. Yes, Mr. Davis.
Thanks, Dr. I assume the window is closed, but in case a district sees this report and says, hey, we want to try to get in this program, is it too late?
It is, according to the dates established. However, again, as I said, if there is someone who wants to create such a program, develop such a program, we have a policy that allows us to bring that to the board.
Thanks.
Very good. Thank you very much.
Thank you.